In this video, I am going to explain important anatomical relationship between upper thorax and lower cervical spines. Particularly, I am going to focus on first rib and lower cervical spines. You know what? What is inside of rib cage? It's lung, right? And lung is covered by membrane that is pleura. Pleura is membrane which covers lung. That said, I say this is first rib. There should be lung and pleura around first rib. Does it make sense? Because, you know, first rib is part of rib cage. Simple enough, right? And I want to focus on one more structure, that is ligament that connects pleura, cervical spines, and first rib. Let's say ligament. So ligament and pleura are connected. What kind of ligament are they? Now it's gonna be today's main topic. Again, there is lung and pleura inside of rib cage. And again, it's very close to first rib. Okay, first ligament I'm gonna talking about is one ligament that connects pleura and first rib. What is this ligament? This is costopleural ligament. Costopleural ligament. Costo means rib. Pleural means, of course, pleura. This ligament connects first rib and pleura, which is on yellow part in this picture. This is number one. Number one. Number two is that connects, let's see, transverse process and pleura. What is the name of this ligament? This is transversal pleural ligament. Easy, right? Transversal, transverse process, and pleura. Okay, next one. Number three is that connects vertebral body and pleura. Vertebral body. So, vertebral pleural ligament. Three connective tissues that connect rib cage and cervical spines. In usual anatomy books, you don't see these connective tissues, but if you Google one of these ligaments, you can see very good picture of relationship among pleura and these ligaments. They are very, very important. Why? Because, you know, what is important thing about pleura and lungs? They are respiratory system, right? It's important for breathing. Okay. These ligaments connect rib and vertebra, then pleura. What happens somehow if these ligaments get tight? Maybe from neck trauma, thorax trauma, car accident, martial arts trauma, any physical trauma can affect these ligaments that can tighten up this connective tissue. What happens to pleura and lungs? Maybe this membranous connection can inhibit the function of breathing. You know, that can happen. I don't say this happens all the time, but this can be one possibility for thorax movement and breathing. Okay, now let me add one more structure. You see yellow structures. What are they? What kind of tissues are these guys? They are brachial plexus. plexus. Brachial plexus means bundle of nerves that sends nervous tissue to upper extremity. You know, this part is originally very narrow space, very crowded space in neutral condition of body. Now let's add many tissues. Vertebropleural ligament, transversal pleural ligament, and costal pleural ligament. Okay, they have very close relationship. Brachial plexus and these ligaments are very close. What happens if you have had whiplash, car accident? Maybe these places are messed up. What can happen? Maybe that tension can tighten up these ligaments. That may affect brachial plexus. That can happen. Then that can create pain around this area. Okay, now there's artery, there is vein, there are neck muscles around this area. You see, this is very crowded place. Physical trauma can mess up this system. Then I focused on ligaments and pleural relationship. Now you can add up many more structures such as brachial plexus, such as neck muscles. Again, this area is freaking important place. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.